Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another spring warbler warm-up video, and this one is going to cover pine warbler. And this one can be a bit tricky at times. It's definitely one you want to use multiple field marks and kind of structural clues and stuff like that. But in general, they have a fairly large bill. By warbler standards, this is pretty large and fairly heavy. The overall plumage, the bright ones are pretty yellow in the head and the chest area, and then kind of turns to more of a white color as you get down towards the belly and the undertail coverts. But actually the drab ones can just be like grayish and basically lack yellow altogether. So that's something to keep an eye out for. You have a whole spectrum from gray to yellow birds. And that's something to be aware of. The cheeks are typically going to be a bit darker compared to the neck area. You can kind of see this contrast here. And you can kind of see that on this bird, although it's not in the best light. But even with a poor view like this, you can still see there's a pretty significant contrast here. There's also, typically on the face, you have kind of a weak eye line and eye arcs. And depending on the plumage of the bird, oftentimes it's the more drab ones that stands out more on. And you can see it almost makes it look like they're wearing goggles or something like that. That's the facial pattern. And in terms of the underside pattern, the streaking, if it's present on the front, is going to be pretty indistinct. And generally, it looks more just like texture than actual streaking. And you can see on this more drab bird, you can see the streaking a little bit better. But in general, it's pretty indistinctive. And pine warblers also have wing bars here. That's definitely something to keep an eye out for, because there's some similar species that don't have wing bars. And then just in terms of the structure, the wing projection is pretty short compared to the long tail. And you can just see how long the tail is from this angle. This isn't the best angle, but on this one you can really see it too. They do have quite long tails. And oftentimes the tail looks notched like this, if they're holding it loosely, which they often do. Almost looks like a finch or something with that strong notch. And pine warblers are actually one of the few warbler species that you might see at your feeder. They do come into suet feeders, and I would say it's one of the few species that you would expect to visit a feeder under normal circumstances. You know, if they're just passing through, they could stop at the feeder. Typically, there's not going to be too many other warbler species that would do that. Maybe in unusual circumstances, one might show up, but pine warblers do it with some regularity. And in terms of similar species, yellow-throated vireo is probably the most similar plumage-wise, so you're not even comparing a warbler to another warbler. So separating those is kind of, you would use the basic structural differences between vireos and warblers kind of as a whole. So vireos have more of a stocky build than warblers do, and also typically have a heavier bill. And the bill also, you can see here, has a little bit of a hook on it. And warblers don't have a hook on the bill. Now that can be a little tricky to see, but generally you do get an impression that it's like a stockier, heavier bird with a vireo like this. And also the legs on vireos are just kind of this gray color, and pine warblers especially often show kind of paler legs. So that's another way to help separate them. And then in terms of warblers, if I run through a couple of the predominantly yellow ones, you have palm warbler. I just did a whole video on palm warbler, so I'll link that in the description if you want to check that out. But you have this Rufus cap, and then there's kind of Rufus streaking on the front typically, and then the Undertail coverts are going to be yellow on a Palm Warbler. So so pretty straightforward to separate that from Pine Warbler. And then you have Yellow Warbler. Again, this is a very yellow bird overall. Yellow Undertail coverts. Oftentimes, they'll have kind of reddish streaking on the front, and then the face is just a solid yellow color with just the eye kind of all with no other pattern. And Prairie Warbler. Prairie Warblers are typically going to have stronger streaking in the sides and then some finer detail in the face, not just kind of the indistinct dark cheek. And Prothonotary Warblers, maybe the most similar in terms of plumage. But you can see, again, just like Yellow Warbler, it's kind of a plain yellow face with just the black eye. And the wings don't have wing bars on Prothonotary Warbler. And I would say the wings contrast more on Prothonotary Warbler as well. So definitely one to be careful with when you're IDing them. But if you use kind of the field marks I just mentioned, Pine Warblers are pretty straightforward. It's not an impossible ID if you use the structural clues and just are aware of the variations in plumage. So if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.